since our arrival in this beautiful and historic city of Jeddah. I consider it an honor and a privilege to stand before you today, and it gives me great pleasure to convey the sincere best wishes of the Bureau and Secretariat of ACTA to our sister organization for the success of this 23rd ACAC General Assembly, the outcome of which I know will galvanize both the organization and its member states towards achieving greater heights in civil aviation. I am sure that you're aware that ACTA has a long history of cooperation with the ACAC, which has assisted our two organizations in their collective efforts towards enhancing the development and promotion of a safe, secure, reliable, economical, and efficient air transport system within the regions, and we at ACTA look forward to continue to grow this partnership in a stronger and more meaningful way. I'll now use this opportunity to bring you up to date on the state of the region in Africa in the intervening period that I have the privilege of standing before you. It will interest you to know that we already, or you may be aware, that based on the results of various studies carried out by the global air transport stakeholders such as ICAO, IATA, Airbus, Boeing, ATAC, air traffic in Africa is expected to double by 2030. Thus, given the increasing connectivity inherent in the establishment of the African Union Agenda, flagship Agenda 2063 of a single African air transport market, and also given the projections show that passengers, goods, airmail, and aircraft movements will continue to grow, Africa will correspondingly need to continue to increase capacity, modernize its fleets, and modernize its airports as well as its air navigation services. Some of the studies, particularly in IATA, sponsored Intervista's report, in which ACTA and its airline counterpart, the African Airlines Association, AFRA, collaborated, have also demonstrated the significant economic benefits to the country from the liberalization of air services markets in Africa through the full implementation of the UNESCO decision. It is estimated that liberalization will create more jobs in the aviation and tourism sectors of the continent, increase member states' annual GDP, and revolutionize interconnectivity within the continent, among others. In this regard, ACTA, my organization, as the executive agency of YD, will support with the support from African Union Commission, the Guardian of the YD, the regional economic communities, and other stakeholders are currently conducting intensive awareness campaigns among states on the urgent need to fully implement the YD towards achieving the establishment of a single air transport market in Africa by 2017, in conformity with the declaration of our heads of states and the AU Agenda 2063. I must inform at this stage that this campaign has met the measure of success, as more and more states are starting to realize that strictly protecting the market for their own airlines is not the way to go if they intend to have a slice of the cake that the service can project. All aviation stakeholders must at the same time be realistic and acknowledge that today we are faced globally with unprecedented challenges in our industry, and this has affected our security and our way of life. Airlines from both regions continue to collaborate and intensify their cooperative efforts, and this has led to the increase in frequencies over time. However, in view of the current challenges, it is important to continue to ensure the security and facilitation of air transport in our regions go hand in hand. Thus, all parties have a shared responsibility to ensure that passengers travel not only safely, but securely. In this regard, I have the pleasure to inform you that just recently in April 2016, the AUC, ICAO, and AFTA convened a ministerial meeting on aviation security and facilitation, where some far-reaching decisions were made. Several targets were set, which are meant to reinforce the is the order of the day. After an year, have a meeting in regular dialogue and exchange of useful information in connection with developments in international civil relations, including on matters pertaining to international civil relations organization. And this has been advantageous to both organizations and these member states in the past. In view of this, AFTAC looks forward to the support of ACAP and all its member states in ensuring the election of all African states to the Council of ICAO during the forthcoming 39th ICAO Assembly. We anticipate working together with ACAP and COSIA, just as we have always done, to provide mutual support to each other and ensure the election of our countries, both AFTAC and ACAP, to the ICAO Council. I cannot end this statement without acknowledging the role ACAP and its member states played in the emergence of Dr. Obi Adeyemi as the president of the ICAO Council in 2019. ACAP and its member states graciously gave us support when his candidature was presented. And for this, AFTAC and its member states, we should thank ACAP and its member states for their support. We also thank you all for accordingly paying the support required to ensure a successful tenure, and we look forward to your support towards the realization of his re-election later this year as the African Union and all African states have thrown their weight behind ensuring that he serves a second term as provided by the relevant ICAO Resolution, Assembly Resolution. As we look forward to closely working with you all to ensure the proper understanding between our two organizations, I wish to assure you that AFTAC will continue to cooperate, collaborate, and forge common approaches with ACAP towards accomplishing our future common objectives. On this note, I would like to once again thank ACAP for the invitation to be part of this assembly. I thank you all for your attention and wish you successful deliberations. Shukran.
Your Excellency, Mr. Minister of Transport of the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, Honorable Ministers of Civil Aviation, the Secretary General of ICAO, Mr. President of the Arab Civil Aviation Commission, Honorable Director General of Civil Aviation, distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen. The European Civil Aviation Conference, ECAT, is very honored to have been invited to speak at this opening ceremony of the General Assembly. We believe this demonstrates how much we value the relationship between our two organizations and how keen we are to consolidate and move further that relationship. Regretfully, the President and Executive Secretary of ECAP, Ms. Ingrid Chetris and Mr. Salvatore Chapitano, were not able to be here with us on this 23rd General Assembly. As the European Director General has our meeting today in Paris as we speak. In this respect, they have asked me to present their apologies and